7-7 at intermission and looking forward to a great second half of the national championship. Now we're ready for a New Year's tradition, the Orange Bowl Halftime Show. Get ready now for a musical cross-country tour.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Orange Bowl Committee proudly presents Broadway and television star Leroy Reams with special guest star Leslie Uggams in a light-up Miami halftime presentation entitled Bright Lights and Big Town Music. And now, here's the star of our show, Leroy Reams.
I got my eye on a trip of imagination, configuration, a bright and melodious trip of sensation round this beautiful nation. I've done all those things to do things, all those rousing and hoop-de-doo things. But if you care to share a wonderful fare, come along and see, take a happiness trip with me. We'll catch some bright lights and that big town music. There's more than we bought. Had a hoedown down in Jackson, watching the lights glow in old Chicago, Manhattan to old Baltimore. You'll know it's the best, it can pass the test of a visit to Miami Shore. So gather round and let's all get on board. There's a great big moon over Miami, lighting the way to Apalachicola,
through Sarasota,
on to Pensacola,
any kind of cola,
have yourself a cola in New Orleans.
It's Mardi Gras time in the land of dreams.
And they've got an angel right here on earth, wearing little blue jeans, way down yonder in New Orleans.
Horace Greeley said it best, on his advice we're heading west.
We'll walk around. You guessed it, you're in Big D. My, oh yes. I mean Big D, little A-double-A-S. And that spells Dallas, where every home's a palace, cause the settlers settle for no less. Back home in Big D. My, oh yes. I mean Big D, little A-double-A. Big D, little A-double-A. Big D, little A-double-A-S. Yes, sir. Just dig a toe in Dallas and there's oil all over your address. When you're in Big D, my oh yes. I mean Big D, little A-double-L-A. Big D, little A-double-L-A. Big D, little A-double-L-A, yes.
Bang on to Hollywood. That's Hooey Valley, Hooey Hollywood. And if you think that you can be an actor, see Maxie Factor, he'd make a monkey look good.
He'll turn you from a into a Michael Fox,
or from a creep into a Meryl Streep.
Hooray for Hollywood!
You know the way to San Jose. We can get there by way of Monterey. And when you think it's time to go, you're just 49 miles from
San Francisco. Open your golden gate. You met a stranger way outside your door. San Francisco, here is your wandering son, saying I'll wander no more.
bells, here we come as a group. To Soldiers Field, Wrigley Field, Marshall Field, and all the
ladies and gentlemen, Leslie Adams.
My kind of town, Chicago is.
Everybody join in as we sing about that St. Louis town.
To Niagara in a sleeper, no vacation could be cheaper, and the train goes slow. Off we're gonna shuffle, shuffle off to Buffalo. For a little silver quarter, we can have the Pullman porter turn the lights down low.
Again, here's Leroy.
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hip hooray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway, the rumble of the subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Maxie's. Good night, baby. Good.
New York, New York.
June Taylor on her choreography. Special thanks to Gene Cockroft, Bill Ledoux, Danny Beck, Peter Gladke, and Helen Lasky. The score created by Milton DeLug with special lyrics by Ann DeLug. Musical arrangement by Chuck Byrd. Right now we'd like to pay special thanks to Orange Bowl Executive Vice President Dan McNamara. For the past 36 years, Dan has contributed endless time and boundless energy to making the Orange Bowl famous for its pageantry. A community leader, a liaison to this event, and a friend to us here at NBC Sports, Dan, we wish you the best in your retirement and happy fishing. The score in the 54th Orange Bowl, Oklahoma 7, Miami 7. We'll be back with the second half and the quest for the national championship. But let's go to Gail Gardner now in New York for a look at the day's bowl action.
Excellent, excellent. Absolutely, that's the key. That's why they're having so much trouble. I still think they ought to try Rodney Anderson, find out if it's Miami's defense or if Lydell Carr is just still rusty. I know he fumbles, but actually,
I'm so happy to see my friends up here too. The Orange Bowl is a wonderful event, and I'm just